Hacksaw, Jim Duggan, Hall of Famer in the WWE.
Well, excuse me, brother, but the first thing Hacksaw has to do is give a big ho! Kind of fires me up, you know, gets the blood flowing, gets the hair standing up, gets old Hacksaw ready to go.
Man, you are ready. You came with all kinds of energy.
Well, you're going to be a wrestler, be a wrestler. You know I love those
guys. I love it. I love it. How'd you pull this off with Vinny? You know Vinny before?
We did a show, a couple of shows. Yeah, it's great the way so many wrestling fans out there all over the world. I've actually done my show in 5 different countries all around the world. Jake the Snake Roberts does it, Mick Foley, and it's you know, so many folks are interested in pro wrestling. They want to see back behind the stage.
You got a huge following.
Oh, and the WWF, that was the heyday of wrestling, you know. And I joke with the NFL guys, I'm like, world champions? Where in the world have you guys been? You know, wrestling, we go all over the world. So
I love it.
You know, it's great to be able to go out and talk to the fans and tell them thanks for all the years of support.
So you're saying pretty much the best thing that happened to you was that injury-plagued first year in the NFL with
the
Falcons.
Well, the NFL, yeah. You know, I thought I'd be playing college or pro ball for years, you know, and I got hurt my first year with the Atlanta Falcons. I was in injured reserve all year. Then I went up to Toronto, tried to play in the CFL for a while. Saw I had no real future in football. Gave Fritz Von Erich, a promoter down in Texas, a call and started my wrestling career.
Okay. And so how would you describe your show? It's a little behind the scenes. If you're a wrestling fan, you got to go.
Yeah, if you're a wrestling fan, and even folks that aren't wrestling fans, you know, a lot of times I get on an airplane next to a businessman. He goes, I'm not a wrestling fan, but hey, how about this? And, you know, it's an intriguing business. A lot of folks are intrigued about our business and want to see backstage. So we have a lot of newbies come, but also we have a lot of true fans that know, you know, I remember 1988, you wrestled One Man Gang, and you know, they know the whole history. So it's great to get out there. I enjoy it. Like I said, it's like talking to a room full of old friends. Yeah. One of the big misconceptions about wrestling, people go, well, you guys are all good friends, aren't you? I said, oh, yeah, we all compete for the same money. We're real good friends. Yeah. Yeah. A wrestling handshake goes with a handshake and a knife in the back at the same time, right? It's a very competitive business, as we were talking earlier. Folks don't see it. They say, wrestling's wrestling. But as a numbers game, you know, there's 1,500 NFL football players, there's 700 NBA basketball players, there's 100 WWE wrestlers. It's television.
Wow.
It's more competitive in sports, and people don't see it that way.
But
it's just not kids from America. You got guys from Japan, Australia, Europe. Everybody's after my job.